Hey, hello guys. Today I'm gonna teach you how to make these liquid gradients that I'm gonna put in the screen right now. Okay guys, so start, we're gonna create a file in 1920 by 1080. And here we're gonna select the gradient option. And then we're gonna select the fourth option of the gradient, which is called reflected gradient. And we're gonna place it in the middle. And we're gonna drag it kind of like that to create this type of horizontal line in the screen. And then we're gonna go to filter and we're gonna go to liquify. After we're on liquify, we're gonna select this one that is called twirl clockwise, or we're just gonna press C. Then we're gonna change the size to 3000. We're gonna make sure that we click pin the edges. And we're just gonna click a little bit just to have this type of horizontal way of the shape. And then we're gonna select this forward wrap tool and making sure that we have the pin the edges selected. We're gonna just increase a little bit the size and we're just gonna try to drag the gradient like that as much as possible just to create that irregular pattern right there. I think this one looks good. I'm gonna click okay. I'm gonna go back to the filters and we're gonna select the filter gallery. Here in the filter gallery, we're gonna go all the way to the sketch filter and we're gonna select the chrome filter. This is gonna make it look metallic and then we're gonna press okay. After we have our chrome filter added to the layer, we're gonna go back to the filter gallery and we're gonna select in the artistic options the film grain. We're gonna reduce that grain a little bit. We're gonna reduce the area just to make it a little darker. Something like this would be fine. I'm gonna press okay and we're gonna have this dark blob on the screen. Don't worry about it, it's gonna look really nice. We're gonna go and we're gonna select a gradient map just to add some color to it. And here are the good news. I put in the description of this video 5 different metallic gradients that you can use in your project. The way that you use them is you just click in here in the gradient options and then you're gonna click import. I have it in the desktop. You're gonna click in the asset and you're gonna click the gradients Photoshop. You're gonna press open and it's gonna add something called gradients Photoshop and it's gonna say liquid metal gradients. You're gonna open that. You're just gonna click here. I think this one looks kind of cool, or the second one. I think this one looks kind of, let's try both. Let me see if I reverse it. Oh, if I reverse it, it looks kind of sick. I like this one more. And after we have our gradient map selected, we're gonna make sure that we select ether and let's try to see how it looks when we change it to classic. I think it looks kind of better. And the next step will be to add some levels to it. And we're gonna make it a little darker, kind of like that. Reduce the mediums a little bit, something like that. And then we're gonna use this like a mask. And we're gonna select the brush with the black color in front. And we're just gonna make it a little big. Let me reduce the hardness to 0%. Just we have something really soft. And we're just gonna dab around and just to make, let me press Shift X just to go back and then just, you know, X. And then just try to make some parts darker, some parts lighter in that particular case. And then we're gonna add another adjustment layer, which is gonna be hue and saturation. And this one we're gonna boost it a little or maybe reduce it a little. I think making it a little darker could work with a little bit more saturation. That'll make it really cool. And we're gonna go back with it and just dab it a little bit in some parts just to make it look kind of different. For the bonus and the last part I already added in this video, this, it's add some noise to it. I create this noise layer for you guys. It's a PNG. You're just gonna drag it and put it on top of the design. And we're gonna select the option overlay. We're just gonna reduce the opacity a little bit, something like that. And here we have our metallic style gradient. If you feel like you learned something new, just give it a like. That'll help me a lot. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.